Good evening, Limited. So today is our topic of discussion. So first of all, to understand what is actually fintech. So fintech is nothing, it's just a combination of finance and technology. It is used to improve and automate the delivery and use the better management of fintech operations, process, lives by utilizing the specialization software and algorithms. It is initially used just for backend activities in established fintech establishment, but later we more focused on customer-oriented services. Currently, many industries such as education, retail banking, foundries, non-profit organizations, and investment managers are use this technology. Now I want to understand what is exactly keywords. So keywords are normally search terms which are generally used to increase traffic on your website. It is used by website owners and SEO professionals. It is helpful in optimize a website in the hope of ranking at the top of the Google search result. So what are the importance of keywords? They can be targeted with the marketing, and they are helpful in increasing website traffic. If we have a good amount of budget, so we can also advertise through Google Ad, which helpful in covered many keywords. So now we look up to some fintech keywords. So the first is algorithmic trading. Algorithmic trading is a computer program that allows us to define a set of instructions to place a trade. It generates a speed profit and frequency that is impossible for a human trader. Instructions are generally based on timing, place, quantity, or any mathematical model. So there are some benefits of algorithmic trading. It helps us to get best possible prices. They provide us accurate and instant trade order placements. It reduces transaction cost, as there is no intermediary involved, and it also reduces manual error risk, and backtest using available historical and real data is also available. Current worth of algorithmic trading in the global market is $11.1 billion, and it is expected to increase up to $18.8 billion till 2024. The next is RoboAdvisor. RoboAdvisor is a software which is algorithm driven financial planning activities, and it collects information from clients and their financial situations for future goals. It offers us advices, and some softwares automatically invest clients' assets by the permission of their clients. In today's world, the total asset managed under RoboAdvisor during 2019 was less than $1 trillion, but it was expected to increase up to $2.2 trillion. There are some benefits for RoboAdvisors, such as it is low cost alternative of traditional advisors. Traditional advisors take around 1 or 2% of total. Clients worth, but these RoboAdvisor take just around 0.1% or 0.5% of total worth of the client. They are also available 24/7, which is not possible for a human. It offers the very minimum requirement of asset for the registration. Even some RoboAdvisor don't need any such kind of requirement. And they are obviously more efficient than a human being. The next is Bheem UPI. Bheem UPI is just a payment app which is more easier than a wallet, and it provides easy and quick transactions. It makes direct bank payments to anyone using UPI. Their UPI ID or scan their QR code with the Bheem app. The total value of UPI transaction during 2020 in January, during 2020, January to September, increased to 3,219 billion dollar from 2,162 billion rupees. There are some benefits of UPI Bheem, such as it is easier than wallet. There is no need to fill those tedious bank details again and again. There is no transaction charges as there is no intermediary involved. It provides us secure transaction. The next is crowdfunding. It is a very, very helpful app which is useful for a small amount of capital, which is useful to collect small amount of capital from a large number of individuals to finance a new business venture. It is easily accessible of vast networks of people through social media and crowdfunding website. The current market size is 12,390 million US dollars and expected to increase up to 23,200 million dollars till 2027. Benefits involved: it provides access to a large and diverse group of investors and supporters. Many crowdfunding projects involve reward based, such as investors get a chance to come in an event or in an inauguration ceremony, and they also get some rewards from the owner side. Computer gaming is a very, very common industry in this kind of practices. The next is crowdsourcing. Under crowdsourcing, anyone can obtain work information or opinion from a large number of group. Sometimes work as a paid freelancer. Some perform small tasks on voluntary basis. Total market value is 9,519 million dollars and expected to increase up to 154,835 million US dollars. There are many benefits of crowdsourcing, such as some are it saves use cost and provide fast work to employer. It has ability to get people with high skills and different opinions. It reduces turnaround time. The next is blockchain. It is a digital record of transaction that stores data in block that are then plain chained together. Blockchain is validated by multiple users on internet. The total current market size in 2021 is 5.88 billion US dollar and expected to increase up to 394 billion US dollar in 2028. Some benefits involved: it has better transparency and enhanced security. It reduces cost. It has true transferability and improves speed and high efficiency. The next is cryptocurrency. It is digital. It is also known as digital and virtual currency, which is nearly impossible to counterfeit or double spend. Many cryptocurrencies are decentralized network based on blockchain technology. The total market value, total market sizes, surpassed around $1 trillion. Some benefits of cryptocurrencies involved: it is easier to transfer funds directly between two parties. There is no need for a trusted third party, and there is very minimum processing cost. The next is API, application programming interface. By using this software, this software works as an intermediary between two applications to talk to each other, like Facebook and WhatsApp. We send a message and anyone can get those messages instantly on their own mobile phone. Then market size is around 3.2 billion US dollars and expected to increase around 6.8 billion dollars till 2025. There are some benefits of API, such as It provides quick and more productive. It provides flexible services, integrated user experience, customer content and services, good data migration support, which helps to anticipate changes. The next is the digital wallet. Digital wallet is a software-based system that securely stores users' payment information and passwords. It can be used in conjunction with mobile payment system. The current market size is around $79.3 billion and expected to increase $154 billion till 2025. There are some benefits of digital wallets. It involves a high acceptance rate. Anyone can make payment with their digital account up to their credit limit, and it is efficient. It is more efficient and it also saves huge time. The next is Know Your Client KYC. It is a standard to use. It is a standard to ensure that investment advisors know detailed information about their clients. It protects both the client and investor advisor. Typically involves requirements and policies such as risk management, customer acceptance policies, and transaction monitoring. And the current market size is around $1.2 billion. There are many benefits of KYC. Some are: it establishes customer's identity, it helps to understand consumer source of fund, it provides protection from frauds and losses due to illegal funds and transactions. Thank you.